I was good, YouTube, back with another video. Third video of the night. I gotta get to bed soon, no cap. I got work dumb early in the morning. But we got another video. We got a different video. It's not a J-Hound video this time, so we're stepping out a little bit, just a little bit. We got Lil Mabu and DJ Osama, Evil Empire. I will say, I remember seeing a clip of it on IG. I don't remember hearing a single bit of the audio from the clip or anything, so this is a fresh reaction. Hopefully YouTube will let me upload this, because like I said before I started recording it and it's on my stream. I remember trying to upload a Lil Mabu video before and it didn't let me, so I'm hoping I could upload this one and this could be Monday's video. But like I said, we're gonna get into it, man. This is gonna be my reaction to Lil Mabu and DJ Osama's Evil Empire. One thing I say, like, Lil Mabu be having fire videos. Like, hit the, like, just the actual video itself be fire.
Yo, bro. Mabu in here stirring anything up with some bitches.
You got something for you. I'm tired of this shit.
Bye-bye.
Nah, the neighborhood crackhead is insane.
Warning, New York City is currently on lockdown. Every op will get shot.
Where does bro get up? Hold up. Where does bro get an RPG from? What type of connectors he have for this? That shit. Lil Mabu is different. I don't know how bro get an RPG in his hand, but fuck it.
Goes to heaven, not hell. So the ops breathing and getting high, not knowing they smoking themselves. Mabu go cool with the deuce. I think the screws on my head a little loose. Like, pass the cane, put a beam on a broom. Bitch, when I up and shaka like a boom. Like, I be acting a fool. Like, when it's just me, my two. My boom, my left, and I steal my right. He like DD, I know Jack.
What the fuck?
Nah, man.
Yo, Mabu, get the fuck up, nigga.
God, get the fuck up.
Yo! Nah, that shit was dumb funny, but that was fire beast switch up, no cap. I fuck with that part of the song. I fuck with that. That was tough.
Niggas without the realness. No, I can't say the last bar. I think that it's time to give Mambo a black card. No, I don't got security with me, but me and Didi got some armed guards.
Like I'm done running laps. Oh, wait, I remember me and my friends talking about this video now. Cause I remember they was like, I didn't hear it. I could be tweaking. But they was, I remember, hold on. I remember me and my friends talking about this. And they was like, I remember them saying I should react to it. Because they were like, Lil Mabu literally said the N-word in it. I haven't heard it. I think it was literally in that part. I think that I just passed. But that shit is common. Hold on. It was literally in that part. Hold on.
I don't know how the fuck you did that. You
you really a young genius. That brain.
You want some of my brain?
Yeah.
Hold on, I'm about to go back to two different parts. I'm gonna go back to this part right here. Hold on.
Mabu missed the move tag. Boom with your ass, leave a bullet in fries.
I'll be back on that drill shit. Me and Mabu too deep trying to kill shit.
No, the ops gonna feel this. Cause they real niggas without the realness.
Oh, that. Okay, there it is right there. Okay.
Did a last ball. I think that it's time to give Mabu a black card. No, I don't got security with me. But me and Didi got some armed guards.
Alright, so he did say it. Alright, but I gotta go back to this part. Cause the beat in this part was this part. I love a good like a little beat switch. You change, like, you don't change up ending OD, but like you change it up enough that like it just sounds fire in that part. I just gotta hear this part again. This song was tough though. Nah, this part is tough. This part is tough. Nah, that was a tough part though. That shit was tough. That song was tough. That song was tough. I gotta tip it, like, the whole little Mabu and Didi Osama duo, like, that's a tough duo. When they hop on a song together, that shit is tough. I'm not about to, like, damn, this is gonna sound type crazy. This is gonna sound type crazy. But like, it's like certain duos, like, okay, I think like the, like, just off the top of my dome, I think like the best New York drill duo that has been, like, speaking mainly like towards the new, I guess like the new age, somewhat old age of New York drill, to me, like, the best duo ever in New York drill is like Sleepy and Chef G. Those are like the top duos. Now, before Pop Smoke passed away, I felt like Lil TJ and Pop Smoke could like become that, like, that Chef G and Sleepy type of duo. Me personally, that's what I thought. Many people have disagreed with me. It's mainly on the Lil TJ part, because not many people think Lil TJ is as good as rapper as I think he is. It's obviously, you know, my favorite rapper. I think he's the king of New York. I'm not giving that title to anybody else. The only person that I gave that title to besides Lil TJ was Pop Smoke, since he passed away. I'm giving it to Lil TJ. We're not giving it. He earned it in my books. Lil TJ is the king of New York. I don't give a fuck what anybody got to say about A Boogie, K Flock, any of them. About all them niggas is nice. Them niggas is like top two, top three, top five drill rappers. And drill rappers are like just New York drill rappers, New York artists, period. New York rappers, artists, whatever you want to call them. Lil TJ is the king of New York to me. But back to this, I feel like Lil Mabu and Didi, like, as they keep on making songs together, they keep on being that duo in the drill scene. Personally, I think they could be like the next Sleepy and Chef G. Now, they're far from it, I will say. They're far from it, because both of them are still like relatively new to rapping, relatively new to the drill rapping scene. So they got a long way to go. But I feel like this duo could definitely be a top two, top three. I say at the very least, like a top five New York drill scene rap duo. I'll say that for sure. But back to this song, this video, but mainly, I'm gonna probably give, this shit was tough, but I'm gonna probably give it like a, the beat was tough, the video is like, again, I'll give it to Lil Mabu. He be having some fire video edits and videos and like just video concepts, period. Both their verses was tough. Nah, Lil Mabu saying the N word is insane, but I'ma give it like a 8. Damn, I'm leaning towards a 9, no cap though. But I'ma say an 8.0. 99. I'm gonna give it a 9 flat. I feel like both their verses was fire, but I feel like what's another like Lil Mob? I'm trying to think of like another Lil Mabu and Didi Osama, like one of their old shits that they did before. Yeah, like Throw. I feel like Throw is a better song than this. Throw is definitely a better song than this. But I would still take. But that doesn't mean like this shit is like Throw to me is Throw a 10 though? Like Throw ain't a 10. It's definitely not a 10. Throw definitely isn't a 10. That's for sure a fact. But Throw is better than this though, I'll say that much. But I'm gonna give this song a 9 flat. The song, like the verses, that's probably the main thing for me. Like I feel like Didi, like Lil Mabu's verse was fire. I feel like Didi's verse could have been a little. Actually, nah, not. Is it a 10? Actually, no cap. Is it a 10? I don't know. I remember giving one song so far that I've reacted to a 10. I don't know. I can't remember which song it was. But I know for a fact one of them. I know for a fact I've given out 1 10. Nah, 9 flat. This song ain't a 10. It's not a 10. 9 flat. But I feel like their verses could have been just a little bit better. I feel like Didi probably had a weaker verse than Lil Mabu. I feel like Didi could have definitely brought more to this verse, brought more to the table. I think the 10 was, what's his name? It was Sugar Hill D-Dot. It wasn't his song. Oh, BBG. I think it was BBG Stepper featuring Sugar Hill D-Dot. Bugging Part, I forgot the name of the song. It was like Bugging Part 2 or Stepping Part 2, something like that. But yeah, I'm gonna give this a 9 flat. The song was tough. The video concept, the video like itself was fire. The bars was fire. The beat was OD tough. The beat switch up in the middle of it was tough. But like I said, 9 flat is what I'm gonna give it. Whatever y'all think in the comment section, y'all let me know. And we'll see what it is. Hopefully, like this video, this was a fire video. I'm hoping that YouTube will let me upload it on Monday. But that's gonna do it here, guys. Thank you again for tuning in. Thank you again for all the love. And I'll say it again. I said in the last two videos, I'll say for this one, I apologize for missing 2 weeks of content. I'll try my best to make sure it doesn't happen again. But y'all already know what I'm about to say. Y'all know how I end up these videos, man. We got merch. We got new merch that just came out, limited edition. Shaker Cup, unfortunately, we only have white so far. There's no black Shaker Cups, but still, for those people who likes the energy supplements or just want to drink or just like Shaker Cups, period, we got that. We got regular comp jackets, pro comp jackets. We got pro hoodies. We got core series jersey, we got V-neck jersey, we got baseball jerseys for the MLB fans out there. I definitely still gotta cop myself a baseball jersey. I want that bad. We got pro tees, we got regular casual tees, we got long sleeve tees, we got joggers, we got pullover hoodies, we got flags. As you can see on my windowsill, I have a flag. We have the pro hoodie. We have the pro hoodie right here that I have on myself. We got it all. We got shot glasses. We got anger cap. I just thought about this, yo, for all the weed smokers out there, yo, we get a trauma rolling tray, yo, hear me out, now, that might be hard to do, because weed isn't legal in all the states, so it might be hard to, like, get that on the store that's sold nationally, but still, just saying, we get a rolling tray, maybe an ashtray, you know, something like that, I don't know, man, I'll definitely... We get one of those two things, I'm copping off the rip. I'm saying it right now. I'll be the first person to get a rolling tray and an ashtray. But like I said, like I was saying, we got mouse mats, we got coffee mugs, we got all of it, man. We got beanies. dad hats, flex hats, snapbacks, all that shit, man. But that's gonna do it here for me. Hope everybody has a good night, good day, whatever time you're watching the video. Damn, this is a long video, 15 minutes too. Hope everybody has a good day and all that shit, man. Good night, whatever time you're watching this. Thank you again for all the love on the video. Yo, the streams are back. The streams are back. I said it in one of the last three videos that I just recorded. I'm trying my best to stream for at the very minimum 200 days in this year that we have left. So I'm trying my best to make sure that the content for streaming and the content for YouTube are consistent in both ways. I'll try my best to keep up with both while I'm at it, but that's gonna do it here. Thank you again for all the love on the content. I've been seeing the numbers on the videos, right? Even though I missed these past 2 weeks, I've been seeing the numbers on the videos like grow and be more consistent. I think I'm averaging like like 20, at least 20 views a video now, unlike before when I was averaging like probably 10. But I'm averaging close to 20 or 30 views a video. So thank you again for all the love that y'all have been showing. That's gonna do it here. Thank you again. I hope everybody has a good day, good night, whatever time you're watching this, and I'll see y'all in the next one. Peace.